Hey guys, what's up? It's HD Rodder here, back with another video. I hope you will have a great 2016. Happy New Year! Alright, so you guys know that I haven't been uploading videos anymore lately, and I wanna apologize for that, but it is really because I got really demotivated. I had a ton of videos lined up for you guys, and they were just crap because I couldn't do anything with them. They were just wrong. I tried to edit them, but the colors were all screwed up, the audio was screwed up, everything just was screwed up. I couldn't do anything with them, and I noticed too late when I already had like 6 or 7 videos, and I really got demotivated because I put so much time into making those. And yeah, that's just the story of my life. But I'm back. And today we are going to learn how to fly fighter in general in Star Wars Battlefront. Alright, let's dive into the fighter squadron mode first. The fighter squadron mode is where you fight in two teams, either one team you're in. For example, when you're in the Imperials, you get to choose one of the two fighters. And when you're in the Rebels, you get to choose one of the two fighters. Personal preference is that with the Imperials, I like to go with the TIE Interceptor, and with the Rebels I like to go with the X-Wing. I don't know if there is anything better about either one of them or worse about either one of them, but that's just my personal preference. Alright, so if you're going with the Imperials, you have a speed boost and a rocket as the special abilities, and when you're going with the Rebels you have a shield and a rocket as special abilities. Right, so when you're going to get into the battle, you're either going to get locked on or you're going to lock on to someone or either one of those at the same time. Now we're going to talk about the first scenario first, getting locked on to. When you're in the battle and you're searching for an opponent and you see yourself getting locked onto, try going into evasive mode. Just try to evade it, evade the lock, and try to see who's behind you. Who is the one that's locking onto you, and try killing him. The thing you have to do, and the thing that I always do, is push the up button so you will make some sort of U-turn and go behind. Then slow down immediately and just turn again. This will make sure that the enemy actually just goes past you, and that you actually will go behind the enemy and will be able to kill him. This works most of the times, but if you're playing against a moderate to highly skilled player in the squadron mode, then this isn't going to work, and you need extra moves for this. And therefore you really need your skills upped by just playing the games, just keep training in the matches, and you will know what to do about this as well. But this is the basic maneuver you have to do. Make the U-turn, slow down immediately, turn around and get behind the guy that was locking onto you. That is one of the best moves that you can make in the basic form, and you will learn what you have to do after this in the matches and when you're training yourself. Alright, so let's move on to the second phase where you're actually locking onto someone. So you found your opponent, you found your enemy fighter, and you want to lock onto it. You can actually auto lock on the target so you will not lose them. Make sure that you're actually with the right stick on the PS4. I don't know how it is on the PC and the Xbox, but with the right stick you want to move around and keep the enemy fighter that you've locked onto in the middle of the screen and shoot them. Just keep shooting them, and most of the time that will just work if they are not putting up evasive moves, obviously. What you also want to do is fire out your homing missiles, and do it as quickly as possible. Just shoot them and fire out your homing missiles. Just keep shooting them, fire out your homing missiles, and when you are fighting against another player, they will not know that you have targeted them, and they will be dead before they know it, because there is actually a delay between the enemy locking onto you and you getting the locked on audio sequence and seeing it on screen. So basically what I'm trying to say is that the enemy, if you're getting locked onto, the enemy already shot their homing missile, and then after a second or so you see that the missile has been fired. There's a small delay, so if you're behind an enemy, like right behind the enemy and you shoot off a homing missile and your laser beams, that it actually means that you most of the time will kill that enemy fighter. It doesn't work all the time, as you can see on the screen right now. This guy was just evading my moves like a complete pro. I was just so eager to kill him that I didn't see that there actually was another fighter targeting me, and therefore I died. And the very core, guys, of air fighting is really team play. If you're up against two players and you're alone and they are moderately good, just moderately, you're just going to get screwed. And that's because when you're following one of the fighters trying to kill him, that means that another fighter is actually behind you killing you. And therefore it's good to have at least a 2v2 battle. At least a 2v2 battle. Because that way you can actually get behind the enemy fighter. Even when it is locking onto you, you still have a chance. So what I'm trying to say is that even if you have incredibly high skills, if you're the top one player in the whole world, you're probably going to get screwed in a 2v1 battle, because there's almost no way that you can win if you're playing against two average people, at least average people. There's just no way in a 2v1 fight. So before I make this video way too long, I hope you enjoyed this video, and the last tip I want to give you is that from the ground, if you're from the ground, you can still air fight. You can still fire your iron torpedoes. And iron torpedoes are so difficult to avoid by being in the air, because you're shooting one way. You can't shoot to the left or the right. You're just shooting up. And the TIE fighters are up and you can't really evade. It's actually harder to evade a ground torpedo than an air torpedo in my opinion. But that's just how I feel about it. You can actually shoot them out of the air, like you can see right here. I think this was kind of an epic move, but don't tell anyone. So yeah. Alright, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope this helped you in the least. Please leave a comment. Please subscribe and like this video if you liked it. And I will be making more videos in the future. And thank you so much for watching. Alright. HD Raw Dot out.